Welcome everyone to another amazing podcast. I don't know if it's necessarily amazing, but I'm Ryan Doris, the curator of your De Novo Hour.
I am Jake. Allen.
Did you miss everybody?
Still. Yeah, I think I've been gone for like 2 now or something.
You've been gone for 2. I'm holding it down. Special guest today.
Special guest, L.S. McClain, all the way from Texas.
We have a fourth person. Come introduce yourself real quick.
He's making some coffee.
Ben's into coffee now. That's weird.
Yeah, he doesn't have a choice. Tired as fuck. And Ben, getting some coffee, but he'll be here.
Ben, background noise.
God, my microphone sends for today. Anyways, L.S. is in town, and we're always glad to have him. He comes around, and it's always a pleasure to have him come lift and come. We get to listen to his rants and his rages and everything like that. So I think L.S. tells this great story of Raw Nationals, and it's kind of what I like to talk about for this podcast. It's kind of I guess we call it the importance of a team or community. And L.S. kind of tell us about how you had a pass, and then like your kind of switching point to when you kind of got on with us, and how it's kind of affected and changed you to some degree.
I mean, we can Tarantino this, I guess. You can Tarantino this real quick. No, so I guess it was about 2 years ago now. Going about 2 years.
Wow, it's been 2 years. Wow.
Yeah, it was Raw Nationals in Denver, and I'm normally I'm a solo guy. I usually do everything pretty much alone. I train alone. Back in my gym in Texas, pretty much by choice. So everything I've done in the past, I want to say 2-3 years, has been pretty much by myself. So I'm just getting prepared, getting ready for the meet, and there's this group of guys that's going on, having a good time, way too good of a time in my opinion. And at the time, I was like, I don't want to send these guys. Aren't respecting the process. They're not respecting the sport. And crazy enough, come to find out, they actually have a lot more respect for the sport than I guess I thought. But at the time, I was just like, these guys are just, they're too crazy, too much laughing, just going too nuts for me. So, I'm in the back. And I guess my thing is, if I can hear you over my music that's on my headphones, it's a wrap. So, of course, I'm hella pissed off, but I mean, it's not like I'm going to say anything. I mean, everyone has a process. So, I guess, that was when everybody was squatted up in lanes. So I was like, all right, it's pretty much like, 5-6 guys and then just me. And, I'm like, oh, who are these guys? Who the hell are these dudes? They won't shut up. Let's just live. Like, how can they even be back here? Like, I don't even know. I said, so I think it was a Matt Gear. I'm pretty sure it was Matt Gear. I was like, I don't understand how, this dude's got his, he can't have his peanut gallery in the back. This doesn't make a lot of sense. Like, there's no spectators back here, blah, blah, blah. And so we get done with warm-ups and we go out, man. And for me, that's kind of my changing point when I saw, this guy's doing well. But not only is he doing well, but his camp is just going nuts for him, And that was like my first time actually seeing Ryan, and this dude's going nuts. I'm like, wait, why is this dude, he's not even lifting. Of course, in my head, I'm like, what is this dude even doing? Like, he was more intense than pretty much anybody.
Anybody, no joke. Yes, yep.
Like no joke.
I don't fuck around.
You saw his cat's eyes, like, but for real though, bro, you're not even lifting. Like, he was just in it. And so kind of, seeing Ryan's, reaction and just how he was just, 100% behind lane, like, it was crazy, And so what you see in the beginning in terms of, these dudes are just, they're just not respecting the process. They're just, they're just out here just having way too much fun. It wasn't just that. I mean, obviously you're gonna have fun, but, at the same time, it was like, people rallying around, their person. That was their dude. We're gonna rally behind you. So, and I really believe a lot of the energy that they brought in the room, like Lane fed off of that. Honestly, people fed off of that, period. And in my opinion, from the outside looking in, that was a big time turning point just for, honestly, for the USAPL in terms of how people have been approaching it in the last like 2 or 3 years in terms of, you want to camp up, you want to make sure that you have a good.
It's been huge.
Yeah. If you look at it now, you rewind it just, honestly, look, 500 days ago, completely different. Like, the feel is completely different. So, it was kind of like that part for me where kind of like my ears kind of perked up, like, dude, these dudes are like, they're making moves, without really making moves. They're just, just kind of fammed up. And then, of course, you know, I think Lane was going for 650. That's when he was going to squat 650. And
everybody went crazy.
You know, people were going nuts, man. But, you know, for me, that's when I saw Ben for the first time. Again, with most of these guys, you hear the name, but you don't necessarily put the name with the face. Honestly, low-key, I thought Ben was like this short little dude. Like, I just thought he was this short, mad scientist from, like, everything that had been described to me.
Tall, lanky.
Like, this tall-ass dude, like, you know, going nuts for Lane. And like, Lane hits a squat and, you know, like Ben goes crazy for him, but it wasn't until his last deadlift that I'm like, I realized, like, dude, this spin dude's fucking huge. Like, he like engulfed him, like, hold on, like, Lane's supposed to be this big dude, and like, Ben like swallows him, like, yeah. Then of course you see Ryan in the back, I see his dreads swinging, like,
dreads, 5'7", you know, 5'7" dreads.
I'm swinging. Not lying to him, like, what is going on with these dudes? But then fast forwarded, I guess, it was Arnold. And then I saw him at the Arnold. I mean, you know, you have to do your research, you know. So I do my little research on everybody, and you know, try to, you know, I started following Ryan, couldn't find Ben. You know, he's just under the radar. And I mean, long story short, I saw him at the Arnold. And I mean, I guess at that point for me, it was like, what can I do to get better? What do I need to do to get better as an individual? I'm doing as much as I can. I'm getting some of the best advice from, you know, some of the best coaches, some of the best lifters in the world, and I'm still not getting to that point that I want to be. I mean, you know how it is. You want to get better. And at some point, you have to realize, like, doing the me thing, doing the solo dolo thing is only going to get you so far, you know, yep. Because there's things you're going to either be your best or your worst critic.
So how did you, like, come to... Because, like, even we had a conversation earlier today, like, self-change is one of the hardest things. And, like, how did you come to terms... with, like, because we're community strong, like, yeah. We're tribed up, like, we're a strong community. So, like, I guess, how did you personally, because I know a lot of people are they're still strong on the idea that I can do this, I don't need a team, I can blah blah blah, like, how did you come to terms with saying, like, kind of embracing us, being like, yo, like, I fuck with this, like, this is okay?
Probably after that deadlift at the Arnold, that final deadlift. Yeah. You know, when we're both pulling for the, you know, we're both pulling for the, Lane and myself, we're both pulling for the win. And, like, I was, on everything, I thought I pulled it. You know what I mean? Like, oh, it's a hitch. Like, fuck out of here. All right, fine. It's a hitch.
Yeah.
But, you know, and then Lane, he went and pulled it. And for me, that was kind of like the final straw. When I saw, like this man, like Ben, went nuts. Like, nuts. I was like, man, that's what it's about. For me, that was like, for me, that's what it was about. I mean,
it reminds you of football again.
Yeah, man. It's, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
That's on point. Like, almost exactly on point. You know, like, the quarterback being excited for the running back. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, straight up. I mean, that's the easiest way I can
describe it. Like, when I see, I was looking at these highlights with Cam and Newton and his teammates, like, and even Ben said earlier, it's like, they just have a strong team this year. Like, everybody's dabbing, everybody's dancing, yeah. like the whole team is just on the same page.
Like, you already know right there. Like, Greg Olsen's dabbing. You know, so it's, yeah, I mean, and for me, that's what it was. Like, when I saw, again, I mean, you guys know now, I mean, I'm hella emotional. You know, I'm going to feed off of a lot of that, man. And, you know, it was just me and my girl, dude. You know what I mean? Like, she's trying to handle me, and it was her second meet ever to go to. You know, and I just thank God that she's good with, you know, probability and great with ratios and amazing with math, you know, because that she was doing everything based off of the projections that she believed everybody else was going to have. And it kept me in the game.
Wow.
But
that's amazing. Shout out to her, actually. Yeah, wow, that's actually, like, amazing.
She's nasty.
I knew that and I was intimidated.
Yeah, she's nasty with it, man. Like, she's really, really good with it. Wow. So, I mean, to, you know, you have somebody with a strong physics background that, you know, that's literally keeping you in the game, that knows nothing about the lifts, knows nothing about the
individual. Dude, that's insane to think that logic and not even knowing about really how to play the sport can get you that far. Like, if you just follow with the straightforward logic of numbers, dude,
that's
and knowing
all I've ever done.
And,
I mean,
yeah.
You know, so, I mean, from Jump Street, I've never really known numbers. I knew projection. I knew what I, you know, how it felt. And I knew how to listen to my body. That was pretty much all I ever knew. So as an individual, right, that's all you can do. You can only, you know, I mean, I have Morpheus now. So, I mean, I don't necessarily have to do the thinking that I had to do before, but it was like, okay, I have to be my own coach. I have to do my own technique. Right. I have to think of these numbers, you know, and I'm not sure if I know about these numbers the way that I think I know about these numbers. So I'm like, you know, I have to go get my girl. Okay, this is what I'm thinking, you know, and so then we would, no joke, dude, we would literally take mathematical theorems, mathematical equations, and try to just pretty much take add weight to it and predict what we thought I would be. And, you know, that's considering, you know, that's if it's a perfect scenario. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, let's be real, I got in the game late. You know what I mean? So, I mean, I have football injuries and track injuries and stuff, but chasing dreams prior to, you know, prior to powerlifting. So, you know, not taking into account any of those things. So, and that's the way we've operated pretty much for the first like 2.5-3 years. And, you know, like I said, seeing you guys at Raw Nats in Denver, and then of course seeing Ben at the Arnold just go nuts for him after that final pull. Like, I was like, dude, why am I trying to do this by myself when there's clearly somebody that knows more than I do? And it wasn't I don't care about stepping on toes. It was like, I want to be better. Exactly. That's the best person I see in the game right now.
All
right. You know what I mean? And I mean, no disrespect to Matt Gary, no disrespect to Mike, no disrespect to any of those other, you know, programmers and coaches out there. But for my baby Browns, that was the best person I saw in the game. You know what I mean?
And yeah, but I think it ties back kind of to the topic. It's like, dude, like, I love Ben, but Ben's not the smartest guy out there. It's just that. What are you talking about? It's just that to tie that in to kind of, man, like we said, to make it work like a Megatron.
Yeah, but
that's where it gets scary. Is if you do your job, you do your job, you do your, like.
And it's, you always say this, like, especially with like, or in reference to like corporation or institution, it's like, it feels like cheating almost, because it's like a super, it's like a super person.
Yes. 100%. I mean, and like, I'm on some, like right now, I'm on some just thank you shit right now. You know what I mean? Pretty much, well, I want to say about every couple weeks, I'm texting like, dog, we're eating right now.
We're
doing this and we're doing that. We're doing this and doing that. So, and you know, just from the jump, just kind of seeing that, wanting to be a part of that, and just seeing like his reaction in the way, his interaction. I think that's the biggest thing. You guys' interaction, you know, not just with Lane, but with one another. I'm like, man, I like that. I miss that. I want to be a part of that. You know, so then I approached him, and I mean, it was just, you know, it was a man-to-man thing, you know, and it wasn't like, hey, I want you to pick me up. It was like, hey, man, I need help. I just want you to help me. You know what I mean? And, you know, whatever you can do to help me, please, I would appreciate it. And honestly, I've gone to a lot of people like that just to ask for help. And most of the time, people are willing to help you if they know you're genuine and it's coming from the right place. I mean, I'm not trying to, you know, I'm not trying to beat anybody, but I'm trying to beat me yesterday.
Right.
Yeah. I'm trying to be the best me that I can be. And if the best me, you know, is on the other side of his coaching, on the other side of his advice, then so be it. We got to get it. We got to eat.
You know, so that's a... It's crazy because, like, I always say it, like, about, especially, like, when my position's de novo, and I always say, like, I just keep the vision moving. Like, it's not my job to, like, tell, but, like, just make sure you do your job, you do your job, you do your job, and, like, to keep everyone in line to make sure that we're doing what we need to do. All, so, like, it's crazy because, like, I'm just listening to you, and I don't think I realized it till now. It's like Jake said, a team is almost, like, cheating in a way because it's, like, oh God, I don't gotta worry about fucking, man, doing this. Like, it's relieving. Yes.
But
it's
that's the incredible thing about like that, and just like community in general. Like when I, like this past Raw Nationals at Scranton, it was kind of like, that was like my first like big meet, like being kind of behind the scenes like with everybody, and just kind of seeing like everyone kind of like tag team stuff and just kind of like work as a unit.
It's
like
symbiotic,
I think,
dude.
That's gonna be like, that's gonna start becoming the new standard. Like, why would you try to do it by yourself, like at this point?
Ego, man.
At this point,
you know what,
like,
I
you
mean,
said
I,
getting
I,
in
I gotta get
way.
Ben on the mic, sit
like,
here.
Yeah.
I'm getting another chair.
I feel a lot of some of it is ego. Like, for me, you know, for me it wasn't necessarily just, it wasn't ego. Well, ego kind of keeps you staying by yourself. A lot of times it's just not being educated and not knowing, like, you know what, I can get so much better with help.
And you're just probably like so much like in your own thing, like,
and
you're not really,
you know, and you're ignorant to some of the things, you just, you don't know any better sometimes.
Yeah.
So, and for the first, you know, couple years, I just didn't know any better. Like, I thought this is pretty much how, I mean, because, you know, a lot of old school guys, that's how they did it. You know, that's how they did it back in the day. They just, you know, I'm doing it by myself. I maybe have one coach. He communicates with me occasionally, and then it is what it is. You know, so for a while, that's pretty much all I knew. And then I saw, like, wait a minute. This guy can do this. He can do this. He can do this. He can do this. And, you know, regardless of what his numbers are, you know, your coach is getting the best out of you. And regardless of what your numbers are, and your numbers keep going up and up and up, regardless of how hard I'm working. I would like to think that there's not a person out there that works harder than I do, but, you know, there is a lot of people out there that work smarter than I had been working. And so that's when it was like, why am I breaking my back and getting the same result? I mean, I want to be better than I was yesterday. I mean, well, what in this equation needs to be changed for me to be better than the LS 24 hours ago? You know what I mean? And, you know, seeing him, seeing his reaction, you know, just to that last deadlift, that was it for me. Like, I'm all about the emotion. You know what I mean? And when I feel what they're feeling, regardless if I'm winning or losing, that was my point. Like, I need to be a part of that. I want that in my life. Not necessarily be a part of that, but I want that in my life. So I approached him, and, you know, I don't even know. It was about a month later, maybe? It wasn't even that.
You were here. Yeah, you came here.
I came, and, you know, I mean, he broke me down and you know, freaking squats and everything. Literally did it all. Just broke me down and everything. And I was driving home, and Brian, I don't know that I've ever felt so proud of myself. You know what I mean? Like, and I'm not even like sitting in front like, oh, you know, it was great, it was such an awesome experience. It was hell. I was embarrassed as hell. You know what I mean? Like, low key, you don't realize how much you don't know until you realize you don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, and so a lot of guys, kind of like Keenan, what he said in terms of being, you know, not necessarily, you know, prideful, but ignorant to a lot of things. You just don't know that you don't know any better.
You know what that is, low key? That's evolutionary advantage, and you don't even know what you just did. Like, that's been done in history. Like, we used to live alone. We used to be animals. We had our maybe family, one or two members. Then somebody finally broke down and was like, "Look, dude, I'm really good at this corn thing. Like, can you just do the? Can you do the animal hunting?
Can you do the gas? Yeah. Like,
but
I'm really good at corn, bro."
Here, I think the kind of connecting point to this whole conversation, at least what I'm hearing. And where it becomes so important for the individual within the group is to know and accept their place. And I'm not saying you should, you know, anybody should ever put themselves down to something that is beneath them or something, but I think everybody has an inherent skill set, and I think it comes out when you get into a group of what I'm just going to call it superpowers, what I believe, because obviously everybody's here because we're all talented individuals. Like, and I think when you're the individual, like you were saying before, when you were lifting as yourself, I think, I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's like a belief that fuels you to keep going, or if it's just you've done so well on your own with things, you just say to yourself, well, I'm good, and who says I can't be the best by just keep... If I've gotten great myself, why can't I be the best myself? Yeah. And then I think you surround yourself with complementary skill sets, and it's like, okay, I was just good.
Yeah.
Great is...
That's exactly... That's right on.
And I think the beauty of that, and this has happened now multiple times, and it's funny because just like Ryan said, as we listened to you, like, you know, things kind of hit me too. And it's funny because I think of it in one perspective of like, when I came into this, like, originally in the beginning... And this is the irony of it. I remember when I was on the bodybuilding forums, like bodybuilding.com, I wanted to be a Salvation sponsored athlete more than anything in the world. I wanted to be a natural pro bodybuilder more than anything in the world. I made products to make products, but I was going to be an athlete on the company. Now, I don't deserve to be an athlete. I will never be an athlete for DeNovo Nutrition. I know my role. And so the beauty is like, being around actually great athletes is like, okay, my job is to help great athletes be as great as they possibly can. I'm never going to be that role. So the other thing too is that, and I think you keep going through this humbling journey of like even starting this, like Ryan, you and I have had this conversation numerous times, is like, I realized a long time ago I couldn't do it myself. And I think it's abundantly clear that, yeah. Like, so anyway, the point is that I think when you can actually step back and say, I can't be the omnipotent, you know, all being master, all knowing master, things just start to come into your life. And it's like, and if you allow them in and you find and see complementary skill sets, it just starts to happen, and it starts to just kind of ebb and flow.
It's interesting because I think de novo is like a little weird because we're all together now. But I think originally we were all like extremely
frustrated
and like, but self-reliant people, like that were
stubbornly
just,
independent.
Yeah. Just like on our own. Okay. Like I'm just going to do my thing. Like, and I'm going to do everything. And like, I don't have to talk to anybody. I don't need anybody. And then, yeah, like you said, we all kind of like come together. So like, in this setting, this kind of ties into like our conversation like way earlier, like it, you can feel like reluctant to like just like do the Bill Burr and just like let it go, like just let that other thing go, and you're gonna be so much happier. And like it feels weird because it feels like you should be it feels like you should still be trying to do everything.
Yep.
But it's like, I was telling Ryan the other day that like, so we have this like company thing, this,
cat check it.
It's basically this program we use so that we can all like talk to each other, 'cause we're all like all over the place all the time, and it connects to your phone and stuff. For like the most recent like mental muscle that came out, like Anna and like Brandon were talking, like I wasn't talking to them, but like I can see them talking in like the channel, and like I was like watching it happen, and like I didn't like I just happened to like pop on and like start looking at it, and I was like, oh my god, that's weird, like they're doing something that like indirectly like benefits me, but like I don't even know it's happening.
What's going on?
It's like, wow, if you just let it go and like people just do their thing.
Dude,
like,
and it's amazing when like you say, when you know your role. Like I always say, like, and I hope if anyone wants to be a CEO, like the role that you need to know is just to know fucking everything, know everyone's strength, know everyone's weakness, know everyone's job, and just don't try to strong arm people. So that's why I'm like, okay, I know everything that's going on. They got it. LS, you got this. Like, Ben's got it. I can see. And it's like, it's amazing, dude. And it's like, Ben might be out on the loop on something. Like, what's this? Blah, blah, blah. I'm like, it'll happen. But like, he's still in a transition where it's like, he's so used to knowing everything, but that's not his role anymore.
Yeah.
Like, of course, if he asks, I'll tell him. I'm gonna be like, none of your fucking business. but it's like, you don't need to be, you don't need to be up on it anymore. Like, Jake, he always comes in and he has this look like, I have no fucking clue what's going on.
Yeah.
Like, and you look like you have no idea. It's like, is this even worth it? Am I even making any progress?
Yeah.
And you do the dude, I know you, like, we talk a lot, and you're just like, you're like, I hope I'm doing good enough. I don't know. Like, am I giving enough value? And dude, like, as the, I guess, somewhat overseer, like, dude, like, back to what Jake was saying, and Ben, like, and all of us, I think we were all, like, individuals, but, like, I got to a point where, like, it just dominoed effect. Like, and I met Ben, and I think it was the same mutual respect for Ben and I. I was like, yo, this dude's good. Yeah. Like, and it was one of the first good people I met that I was
just
like,
good, genuine.
I can never be that excellent. No. Like, we need to team up. And then, like, Jay came in, and then, like, he started doing shit, and we were like, you see that fucking shit? This kid, like, and I was like, I can't do, like, dude, and it's amazing when, like, I guess the importance community is like, I guess like trust is a factor, of course, but it's like, if you think that you can do it all on your own, like you're only gonna be as good as your best strengths.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
That's the best that she'll be. So, like, without everyone here, like, you would have just been just a strong dude.
Yeah.
You wouldn't have the finesse. Like, you wouldn't have the longevity. Like, you would have fucked up.
Oh, I've been hurt a long time. I know that for a fact.
Yeah.
You know, I've told him a lot. I mean, that was kind of one of the first things that, you know, that we discussed was, like, you know, be completely transparent and at the same time be 100% honest in terms of how your body feels, where you're sitting at, you know, where you know, where you think you want to go. And, you know, and I'm at the point now that, I mean, and I've told him many times that, I mean, I've even put it on my social media, like, I trust this man with my life in terms of, you know, what I want to do, what I want to accomplish. And I mean, there's sometimes I just kind of look at the, you know, I look at the work, you know, the workload in front. I'm like, I don't even, what? Seriously? You know what I mean? Like, we were just talking about that. Like,
yeah.
I literally get mad. And again, so I get angry with him, you know what I mean? Like, this nigga's making me do this, what? And then my girl looked at me like, would you just call Ben? Yes, I did. Yes, I did. You know what I mean? So, and again, it cracks me up now, but I mean, and I would tell him, like, listen, sometimes I might not like it, but I mean, I love it in the end. I know I'm going to get stronger. I know I'm going to get better. And there's, you know, there's so many, you know, there's so many lessons outside of just the actual, like, just putting something, picking something up, putting it down that you learn. But I think the biggest thing for me in terms of just this community, this, I mean, honestly, the corporate comment that's kind of been set is just everyone wants to eat, number one.
Yep.
But we're not trying to eat at each other's expense, which is crazy.
Yep.
And
yep, you don't find that.
As a result of that, just we're all getting full, but that hunger hasn't stopped. Which, and it's crazy because I'm sitting in the gym. It was the day before yesterday, and I texted Ryan on some just, you know, I'm
they have no idea what's going on. Like, they're not ready.
Yeah, like, just they don't even know. Like, I don't know.
No,
I don't.
But you know what it is though? It's like, and I'm not talking about, I don't want to make this de novo heavy, I just use us as examples because that's what,
yeah,
I know, but like, we just don't want to lose. Like,
yeah,
I've realized,
yeah,
that especially in the world of academia, like, we've all been in school in this room, so you,
yeah,
see people who are like good,
yep,
and you see how they're good. It's because they have a great board, they have,
yep,
great camaraderie, like, they,
yes,
have great, like, because they, like, they have good people they can relate to. And like, I saw that, and I think it's going on in our industry. Like, if people don't get it sooner than later, it's that, one, you won't be able to compete.
No.
Kind of going back to, like, the evolutionary advantage thing, it's like, I always think, like, man, I should just move. And then, like, I always think, where the fuck am I going to move?
Yeah.
Like, you can start in your own country, but good luck.
Yeah.
Like, where am I going to get these resources from? You know what I mean? So, and I think we're at the point of our industry where, I mean, it's not the Ed Cohn days anymore.
Mm-mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if,
yeah,
you want to, one, have a great coach, two, you got, people want to recognize you got to have a great brand. Like, think about the teams, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
You think SSPT.
Yeah.
It's a facility. There's money in there. There's years of knowledge.
There's years of knowledge.
You,
yeah,
know what I'm,
man,
saying? Like, it's a brand that's put in, and it's a team. It's not just Mac.
And it's taking time.
Exactly. And I think for anyone in the fitness industry, they have to know that, like, the tide has turned on your competition now. Like, you have, like, the people you're fucking with aren't juniors anymore.
No.
Like, the amateur days are long gone.
Yeah, there's people that come in the game that have just as much knowledge as people that have been in the game for years and years and years. You know,
yep,
so coming in that, you know, with a bit of respect for, you know, not necessarily opposition, but, you know, just, I guess, for the industry in itself, I mean, it almost gives you, not necessarily a leg up, but, it, I mean, it gives you at least a step ahead in terms of just that respect and knowing, like, it's not, like you said, not like the Ed Cohn days anymore. It's, you know, people are coming in with just as much knowledge as anyone. So that's cool to have that knowledge.
Even more, all,
yeah,
the,
yeah, yeah, you know,
yeah,
it, it's cool to have that knowledge and you know, to have a million degrees and all that good stuff. But if you don't have a team to use that along with, it's pointless. You know what I mean? Like, there's a lot of hella strong dude. There's people that will lift holes, you know, circles around me.
Yep.
You know, but,
yep,
they're never gonna have that opportunity because they choose to try to do it by themselves. And that the key word is try. You can try and try and try and try, but you will never be as successful as you could just by just having just some person just, hey, man, try switching your feet. Right?
But you said,
yeah,
something really key there, though, a while ago, was if you don't know, you don't know.
You don't know.
That's very true.
And that's, I think the problem is, man, I will never be someone to say, that doing things your own way is wrong.
Yeah.
Because yeah. We've already said it, we're all pretty stubborn too and independent. However, sometimes doing things your own way means trying new things out. And I think a huge part is you know, this conversation is kind of revolves around a lot of different themes, but one of them that I think we haven't touched on yet is the theme of really just diving fully into something and getting almost in over your head. Because what happens when you do that is, and this is a huge thing, I think, at least, you know, in my own life, I could say, is you need a frame of reference.
Yeah.
And if you only ever dabble, you never have a frame of reference.
True story.
Yeah.
Because what happens is you just say, okay, that feels good on my toe.
Yeah.
Okay, my toe's cool now. I'm going to take my toe out and let my toe cool off. But when you just dive in head first, you have to find a way out or you die and you drown.
Right.
And I think a big thing with this and with certainly the direction, you know, the industry is going is like, man, if you haven't fully dove, then I think there's a certain gear that you aren't aware of to touch because all you see is what everybody else is doing. Yeah. And that's the new limit somebody else set. So that's as far as I can go. But someone's got to test that new water. You know what I mean?
Very true.
So I guess what I'm saying in a very, I'm leaving it a little bit ambiguous is like, man, experiment.
Yeah.
I mean, because sometimes all you see is the surface or, you know, a little bit, just further enough, you know, maybe a foot below the surface and that's it. And that's, for me, that's all I ever saw. I was like, man, I mean, these guys are awesome. They're good dudes. I mean, Scott Ben, he knows his stuff. And that was pretty much it. That's all I knew, you know? I mean, let's be honest. I didn't know a lot about the guy. I couldn't find anything social media-wise on him. Like, oh, he has Facebook. Who doesn't? My grandma has one. That's what's up. You know, like, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't know a lot about him, you know? And, you know, you can't necessarily gain a lot of information on an individual by, you know, through Ryan or from Jake.
Yeah,
I mean, I still didn't know a lot of, you know, so.
Sure.
What I saw was pretty much what I saw.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, and I saw enough, but for me, a lot of it's just, I'm really big on, I have a lot of blind trust. I will trust anybody at any given point in time. And I was like, dude, that's somebody I could trust. You know what I mean? Somebody, if he's willing to, in this macho, machismo world, man, if this guy's willing to just embrace a grown man in front of everybody.
I don't fucking care.
You know what I mean? It is what it is. So,
well, you know what the difference is with, you know what the difference is with that embrace? And why you don't see it much is because, like, in this industry, like you said, the surface, what so many people see, they see, let's say somebody popular, Michelle Lewin or Michael Hearn, right? It's popular people. They say, oh, better yet, let's do a friend. Like, let's do Mike T. Share. Mike T is a brand,
yes.
Right? He is a brand. Like, and what people don't understand is that Mike T is the facade of a brand. Like, Mike has Adam. Like, Mike's got a team that have the Mike T business. And so many people think it's the Mike T business. It's not Mike T.
Yeah.
And so many people think, like, oh, well, that's Mike. Mike won. No. Like, Mike's team won that day. Like, the whole RTS won that day. So, like, when one of ours wins, like, on the surface, it looks like, oh, yeah, that's LS. LS did great. Like, dude, the team has put in so much for the LS brand to win, sure. And I think, like, that's the fundamental confusion in this industry is that on the surface they see, like, oh shit, Ryan's got this many followers, Ryan must be
right.
Yeah,
not even fucking close.
Like, and that's why, though, like, LS, like, you mentioned that, like that big hug that, like, Ben gave to Lane, but that's why we can get so excited and so,
because you feel it
invested in each other. It's like, man, if I'll just be on, like, Instagram, like, doing something, like, I'll scroll through, I'll see LS, like, doing a lift, I'll be like, good, like, and I'll see, like, some other tribe member, like,
yeah,
doing,
like,
something,
yeah,
like, good, good, okay, good. Yeah. And then, like, Ben will be, like, going in, like, hard on, like, some chemistry stuff, and I'll be like, okay, good, yeah. Okay, good. And yeah,
then, like, always right in the world.
We'll be watching anime. Yeah.
And it's like, you can get excited for that because we're not trying to fight each other. It's
yeah.
like
yeah, we're not at each yeah. other's throats.
Yeah, like that. Like they get to you get to that person gets to fulfill what they want to do, and we support them. And in doing what they want, they support everybody else. Yeah. So it's like
talking about the big other.
Yep. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's like, gee. I'm happy when I ever I see like any de novo person succeeding in like whatever anything they want to do, because I like I love seeing people like doing what they yeah. want to do.
Greatness it's, be great, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's nothing better yeah. than seeing that. It is the best, dude.
That was one of the first things you guys told me when I walked in. Like when I walked in here. You know, that was one of the first things, you know, these guys that you talked to me about was just, you know, great being great and wanting, you know, wanting good people to be great. And it took, again, it takes me a little bit to wrap a lot of things because, like, I tend to get, I get caught up in the emotional, like, aspect of it all, man. I'm like, I can't believe this is happening. Like, you know, it's, I just, you know, I love that feeling, you know. I mean, I may not remember a word that you said, but I remember exactly how it felt.
Sure.
And I can recreate that moment in my mind over and over and over again. Maybe not remember your words, but I can remember
exactly. Episodic memory.
So with, you know, and again, I refer to the, if you have noticed, I refer back to Raw Nationals and I refer back to
feelings, yeah.
Because
yeah.
I remember that feeling. My B. I remember that feeling of, man, that's crazy. Like, you know, yeah. like, I just remember the feeling. And to recreate that feeling, the only way you're going to be able to really recreate that feeling for yourself is you have to be a part of that.
Yeah.
Straight up. There's no way around it. Like, certainly, my experience may be a little bit different. Hell, who knows? My experience may be better. But I'm never going to know if all I see is just, you know, I only see half of a foot. You know, I mean, Ned said you got to dive in all the way. So I'm like, you know what? This guy might laugh at me if I come and approach him, but I mean, I want to be better than than I was, you know, 24 hours ago. So I approached him and it was as cool can be. And, you know, I mean, fast forward, you know, X amount of days, you know, forward and, you know, we're here now. And it's, you know, I feel like I think I put more work in now than I ever had as an individual. I'll say that again. Yeah. And I'll say that, yeah, I'll say that a million times over. And when you hear me well, I work harder now as part of a team than I ever did as an individual. I mean, you know, Ryan, you nailed it. It's that team pressure because, you know, I say it all the time. If I eat, we all eat.
There's an extra carrot dangling in front
yeah.
of your face.
Yeah, like,
now.
You know what I mean? Like, if, you know, and I've always felt that way, but it was more for me and for mine, for my family, you know, for my loved ones. You know, now it's like the family's extended. So, when I eat, we all have to eat. And in order for us all to eat, you know, if it's, you know what, I got to get this one last set in. All right, awesome. I knocked this set out. I'm going to make sure that I hashtag this to Novo Nutrition so people know this is where I'm from. This is what I'm representing. And, you know, everyone that's a part of the tribe, again, a thing that I, you know, once we, you know, once we formed the tribe, the thing that I tried to make sure that I did was obviously try to follow as many of the people as possible. But I go through everyone's social media and I try to, you know, not necessarily like it, but at least observe what they're doing. You know yeah. what I mean? And so in that rare occasion that they might DM me or write me, I'm like, hey man, by the way, I saw you rip out that, you know, that 465.
You have AMRAP. Information that's yeah, like, oh, yeah, man, yeah. I've been following yeah. you too. And,
yeah. You know what I mean? I mean, because, I mean, it's no secret. Everybody in that tribe, they show us crazy love. You know, and so it's as simple as showing that love back, but then realizing, man, you know, in showing that love back, you realize how invested you are into their success. And, you know, and it's vice versa. So it's like, why? Kind of like you were saying before, Jake, when you see somebody being successful, you feel that success, you're excited for them,
yeah.
you know, because not really being selfish about it, but we're all benefiting from that success because
yep.
everyone's, you know, again, alluding back to what we talked about before, you know, I guess in everyone being individuals, you know, in those prehistoric tribes,
yep.
you know, hey, I'm a great hunter. You're a great farmer. You're really good at copper. You're great at stonework. Well, that's what we're all doing right now. Right? Yeah. Hey, you know, I'm awesome at hunting, dude. Let me bring back, hey, I got ox for you. What you want?
I thought I was a good hunter until I met you.
Yo, man, serious.
Yeah. I'm a fucking warehouse manager. Organize some boxes.
but everybody, you know, everybody has, like, something they bring to the table. You know, and that's, for me, that's the crazy thing. And I know I told Ben and asked, because every now and again, like, Ben don't have information. He'll want to try to, you know, share it with me, you know, a little bit here and there. I'm like, dude, I don't even want to know. I don't want to know yet. I mean, I want to focus on my hunting right now.
But you know what, dude? Like, you brought up a good point, and I've never thought about this till now. There's a distinct difference with, we use the word tribe because that's our behavior.
Yeah.
Like, we literally... Like, I have a DN insignia on me. Like, that's, like, my mark. Like, I live and breathe the Novo. And I think what I see with a lot of teams, I see a lot of collusion.
Mm-hmm.
Inclusion is a term in economics when people come together to, like, kind of stop other people.
Exactly.
It's like, if the five of us can come together, we create a team, and we'll be better than them. And it's almost like they're teaming up out of fear.
Yeah.
In a way. Like,
yep.
I think with our tribe, it's like, yo, dude, I 100%... respect your like, I'm not trying to create an embargo on the market or on money. Like, I just see your talent. I want your greatness to be great, and I think I can teach you something. And I think, like, and dude, it becomes like, my arm was weak, like, god damn, I got a strong arm now. And it's like, can we get like another good leg now, dude? And like I said, Megatron, like, next thing you know, like,
coming together like Voltron, real sick,
dude.
Like,
it's nasty.
Here's the other layer, I guess, to this onion, is that We've talked a lot about de novo, just like as its own thing, but there's de novo, and then there's the next layer, which is, you know, raw powerlifting, and then in USAPL and that community, and then the powerlifting community as a whole, and the fitness community as a whole. So it's like, yeah, we have de novo, and that's really our close-knit, I guess, family or tribe, you could say. But it's not like it's de novo versus like everyone else.
Yep.
And it's crazy because you do see some animosity, I guess, really no matter what you do. And it's like, it's baffling to me because it's like, why would you choose to do that? Like, if you would just, it's the same thing. Like, if you would just, like, let go and just be my friend, like, we can make each other better. Why are you doing that? Like,
this is the funniest thing, is I think it's sometimes difficult to always realize that in every response you want to have to a situation, that there's an option. And I think people forget that, especially when they say, I don't have that. I want that right now. Like,
yeah.
And while I understand that, because, dude, we're all human. That's a human emotion. That's a human experience. However, the thing about it is, you can hate somebody from a distance, but you're always hating your perception of that person. You don't actually know what you're hating. You're hating something you created, not what reality might be. So the alternative option is find out what the reality is,
mm-hmm.
and approach it indifferently, not with your perception going in, and you might get something different out of it.
Right.
The reason everybody's here is because we all approach each other that way. And here's the thing, is like, all of these concepts we're talking about, I'm sure they're universal concepts for any people who got together, wanted to start some kind of thing, and are moving in good direction with good momentum. Like, there's no secret formula other than, like, and dude, we had this conversation, like, get out of your own way. Mm-hmm. And if not, you can get mad at the world until you're the only person sitting in your cell
by yourself.
Exactly. And everybody else has gone on to do but greater things. Like, and it's fine. Like, I'm going to be indifferent. I'm not going to get mad at you if you hate. I'm not going to feel bad. I'm going to be indifferent because the option's there.
Yeah.
It's an open door. It's just, you got to know how to go into the door. You can't go into it and, like,
jump off like
yeah, anyway.
Yeah, it's bigger picture, man. People people they tend to you don't know till you realize you don't know, you know, and
I was on this podcast the other week. Shout out to Ray from the Super Strength Show, or I should know this. the Strength Show? Is that superstrengthshow.com?
Don't look at me.
Shit, I'm sorry, dude. My bad. It's dude. Anyways, his top, like, he's had like Frank Zane on there, Kelly Starr, like he's had like, it's a phenomenal podcast. Dude, like, we were talking before and he had like, he just sounded like a regular dude. Like, I met him, I didn't think much of him. He's like, "All right, Ryan, you ready?" And then he cued on some music. His assistant like was like, "You ready?" Blah blah blah. And then they counted me down and shit, and they were like, and he was like, "Welcome." And I was like, "What the fuck? Where that voice come?" Dude, their podcast was so fucking good.
Just nice.
Dude, it made me like, just, he was like, "You guys got podcasts, right?" And I was like, "Yeah." "I bought these microphones on Amazon and I record." Like, dude, like, but here's the thing though, it was, his podcast was so good, it made me embarrassed. Like, but what it didn't make me do was get mad at him for being good. Like,
I can't get mad at you for bringing up A1 product.
Dude, I even said it on the podcast. I was like, "Bro, I got love for this. Like, this, seriously, like, bro. I want him to be great. Like, he's, if you want to allocate your time to podcasting, he's got a podcast shirt and logo, and he's making, like, dude, I was like his 170th podcast.
That's
like,
what's up, man.
Dude, like, he's doing amazing. Like, he scheduled me and stuff. But anyways, like, the point I'm trying to make is, like, so much of teamwork, and what people don't see is, like, they see the final product, especially in a consumerism culture.
Yep.
And, like, they don't see, like Utopian's back in stock. Go buy your is back in stock.
Two flavors.
Two new flavors. Dude, people did not see, literally, like, the meetings with just, like, the curse outs. You have to curse people, and, like people didn't see getting one box. Like, people don't see the behind.
Well, I didn't see, but I didn't know any of that.
We got one fucking box delivered, 24 units, dude.
But even leading up to that, like, the year of the sheets, we had everybody come to the house and fill out by testing the single ingredients. Like,
dude,
like, every single process about the label, where we went back and forth on things. Like, it's, like, none of this stuff is, it's not one-dimensional.
Yeah.
It's not.
I mean, I definitely, you know, the more I mean everyone's trying to eat. I mean, that's absolutely evident. But, you know, one of the craziest things is, of course, you know, I would say on the outside looking in, because I feel like I just like feeling new to it all. But I said a lot being on the outside looking in, like, you know, coming into this, all I saw was, again, you see the final product. Yep. And, you know, then when you start seeing, like, you know, like Jake referred to, the onion, the layers, you start seeing, you know, okay, well, this top layer, okay, that's awesome. Peel back one more layer, like, what? They have to do what? Peel back one more, like, wait, they're working out in their home? Peel back another, like, wait, there's always somebody in this house. You peel back another, like, everyone's has input. You peel back another layer, you're like, wait, you guys are doing all of this, trying to get this done, you have to go to the warehouse and all this stuff. So the more, you know, the more information that, you know, naturally tends to, I just naturally absorb, the more you have an appreciation for the work that's put forth. So it's hard, you know, it's hard to see, you know, sometimes when you see the messages and when you see people writing this and people writing that. But then, as Jake's, you know, said before, it's bigger picture. It's not just de novo, you know, it's raw lifting.
Yeah.
And then, of course, when you just get to the whole raw lifting thing, it's, you know, well, then there's raw lifters versus equipped lifters. What's that about?
Yep.
And then, you know, you take it to the next level, then that's just powerlifting in general.
Yep.
Is that even a respectable sport?
Yep.
You know, it's not even an Olympic sport. So then you have the sport in general. And so you rewind it back to, like, oh, I don't like you because of what you're doing, or you're doing something that I don't know about, so I don't appreciate it, whatever it is. It makes absolutely no sense to me, because if you just take two more steps past your porch, you're going to realize, like, bro, what you're worried about is so insignificant. You're about to be on the street.
Yes.
Dude, the longer
you're, like, bickering with each other, when it's like, dude, let's get this sport going.
Yeah,
so,
man,
like, we,
you know,
can,
like,
all
right now. I mean, and this is just in my opinion, right now, this is the most popular powerlifting has ever been, ever been. And it's not just an Ed holding us down. It's not just, you know, a Kaz holding us down. It's multiple lifters out there, multiple associations, multiple federations. I don't care if you're tested or untested, but people are moving legitimate weight.
Yep.
And at the end of the day, you have Joe Schmo sitting at the house, and he sees a number. This guy's benching 500 pounds. He's squatting 800 pounds. He's pulling damn near 1,000 pounds. I can't do that. That's as close as I'm ever going to come to seeing a superhero live.
Yep.
Baby girl, let's get these kids and let's go watch this. It's the truth.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And so when you have an opportunity to reach the masses like you do right now, and there's some actual legitimate personalities out there that I feel like they're benefiting the sport. There's some intelligent individuals out there that are doing more than just lifting. They're speaking and they're talking with people, and they're creating relationships. They're shaking hands. They're kissing babies. They're doing amazing things that we don't necessarily, you know, a lot of people out there don't necessarily see. But there's a lot of people that are really running with this torch for powerlifting that are doing amazing things for the sport just to keep us on the map. And we're not even that big of a dot on the map. Yep. We're a small subculture within a subculture.
Yep. Within a niche.
You know what I mean? And people are just... I said all the time, it's a big enough playground that we all can play. But for some reason, someone wants the sandbox all to themselves. That makes no sense, man.
Dude, it's a small town mentality.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it's natural, you know, a small industry.
Yeah.
You get that small thinking. Like, I was talking to one of my friends. He works for IBM, and he's a pretty high up position in IBM. He lives in New York. And he was just asking me some questions about our industry and something. And then I answered him, and it was about money, I won't say the figure. And he was like, oh, is everyone like that? And I was like, yeah, blah, blah. He's like, what's the largest company you guys have? So I think, don't quote me on this, I think the largest corporation that we have in supplement company, I think they've done like 300 million. And I think that's Ultimate Nutrition.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that's the biggest company we have. Like, that's the biggest company we have. Like, dude, like, think about that. We're fighting over millions and a few billion, while Apple is doing like $60 billion. Yeah. Like, dude, this is, like, there's real things out there. And I think, like, it's the same thing. It's like a crosstown rivalry in powerlifting right now. Well, it's like high school football rivalry, and then I don't even think a lot of people are aware that there's such thing as an NFL, and it's like they would be fucked up if they went and saw a stadium.
Yeah.
You know, and I think, like, for us, especially in this house, like, I'm not gonna lie, like, the industry makes it hard, because it's like we see these little things, and don't get me wrong, we got love for it, and it's like, yeah, but have you seen these guys over here? Like, they're doing something huge, and like, you want to get it, and you want it, like, even like your job you were telling me about, like, it's like, this is an industry,
like people. And that kind of cracks me up, because I'm like, you know, that's... I'm not knocking. I mean, because, I mean, there's some supplement companies out there. I mean, they're moving weight. It's dumb for me to say, but, I mean, they're moving weight. I mean, and, you know, they're moving millions.
Yeah.
But I work for a cheerleading company, man. A cheerleading company. My cheerleading company alone is worth $1 billion by itself. Say what? And people...
Yep.
And it's... Honestly, cheerleading is smaller... It's smaller than powerlifting. I'm gonna take it even a step further. We've been trying hard to get recognized by the IOC to go to the Olympics, to be considered an Olympic sport. Cheerleading just started, but I'm gonna say, started making a legitimate push towards, you know, being recognized by the IOC, and they're already probably half a step ahead of powerlifting.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Even crazier, like, you know, that's how I found out about, you know, Gaston, the IFC president, meeting with my boss that owns Varsity. He's also the chairman of the International Cheerleading Union, and they met and, you know, talked and hung out, I guess, when they were doing some like sport accord meeting or whatever. But yeah, cheerleading's just been introduced over the last like 5 to 6 years, and it's already half a step ahead of powerlifting. Because it's not just...
Why do you think that is?
Well, like we've been talking about, man, people just fighting at each other. I mean, and it didn't even matter about the raw lifting community, but then you have the raw lifting community going against the equipped lifting community.
Yeah,
then,
raw going against raw.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, you know, well, is your raw tested or is not tested? Man, at this point, who cares? Can we eat?
Yeah.
Straight up. Are we going to be around in 4 or 5 years? At this rate, I'm going to say no. Because people are too busy... It's just people too busy pecking and pecking and pecking and pecking. And honestly, at that point, it's gonna just take one corporation, one.
That's.
It's gonna take one corporation with some real money.
So here's the thing, and I know you used to skateboard, and I don't know how much you still do it, but I've been seeing this my whole life. Like, I was into baseball cards, then I was into BMX bikes, mm-hmm. and the like unspoken animosity with that was like skateboarders hate BMXers, yep. BMXers hate rollerbladers, blah. Like,
yeah.
And the thing is. Then guess what? ESPN came in and just bought the whole damn thing out and runs the X Games, and they're still going strong.
Yeah,
there's been like
they breathed life into it. They kept three on the verge of being extinct, you know, hobbies.
Yep,
they've kept them afloat,
alive. Yeah,
people are eating off of it.
You know, same thing with lifting weights though.
It's gonna happen. It, you know, I mean, there's some big players out there. Dude. I mean.
If you fucking coaches don't stop beefing, bodybuilding.com is gonna sweep all your fucking yep. whatever you make, 40 fucking thousand. Dude,
yep.
Stop fucking fighting. I've said this to people in real life. You know who you are. Stop beefing. Like, if we don't get our shit together, it's gonna be swept up and gone.
Yep.
Yeah, man.
Your logo and shell company will be gone along with everything you taught. Stop. Like, we need to get together and create our own, what's the word I'm looking for? As Mike Tyson would say, impregnable.
It's like a union almost.
Yeah. I mean, we're at that point where it takes a village, man, but all the villagers are fighting.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And I don't know. I guess being the son of a preacher, man, I've always believed that people, you know, they have this innate want and will and need to have some form of togetherness. And the more I'm around, I guess, not necessarily just the powerlifting, but just the fitness industry, the more I realize, man, so many people out for self, and that's fine to get yours, but if you need to get yours by stepping on someone else's neck, what's the point of getting yours?
Yep.
It's not honorable, in my opinion.
Dude, but here's the thing. Here's the problem with that. You don't find that out until you're standing at the top of the mountain in your castle alone with nobody in your castle.
I mean, it's
cool. And then you're the most depressed person with the most biggest enormous castle.
And you realize it's a house of cards.
yeah, exactly. But so isn't it sad that you can only find that out once you've gone way too far?
And then your friends don't pick your phone call.
it's just nuts, man. I but yeah, man, community. You know, I don't know, being a part of this, man, and being a part of something that, you know, you realize it's bigger than you. It's been like probably the coolest and crazy experience, you know, at the same time. Because like I said, I, you know, from the jump, all I ever knew was just me, and me. And then to become a part of this and to be asked to be a part of this. And that was the crazy thing, I think. I completely left that part out, was when it all went down the way it went down. You know, and I asked Ben to be, you know, just help me. I just want help. You know, and it took, you know, we're about a month into it. And then, you know, he called me. I'm on the road to Dallas to another cheer event. And, you know, he goes, you want to be a part of the family. Like, no one's ever come at me like that. Like, the only time I've ever heard being a part of a family is, again, like, you know, how Ryan said, being on a football team.
Yeah.
You know, and being a part of a team. And we've approached this, you know, so much like a team.
But that's funny, because I just realized that in saying that, we've all identified with sports as a major part of our life.
Oh, yeah. Very much so.
So, wanting to recreate that, because,
I mean, and this is the closest, you know, as you're ever going to get. I mean, and as a, you know, I mean...